That's how I'm gonna do.
Do you think they end up like this, like in a fighter when they beat you, Roy, or is it you leave it out of the ring after that?
Nothing personal, we're professionals. I kind of just like guys. Scott, they won. I mean,
win this fight.
You're gonna win some, you're gonna lose some. That's part of boxing. Sure. Just like a guy called Steve Burke, man. It's like saying, oh, I'm gonna get mad at the teacher because I flunked the test. Are you serious? You feel me? You can't do that.
Who's the hardest guy you ever either sparred or fought?
The hardest guy? Like, I don't know. It ain't never really been too hard for me to fight nobody. Yeah, it's pretty easy for me.
Nobody
really been that hard. It's just my energy level. The first tall fight when I beat it behind, it was hard because I had no energy and I just came back for that 25-pound loss. That probably was the hardest fight I ever had to fight because I had no energy and I still won with no energy. So what did I tell you? If I can beat you with no energy, then you know you're not really a factor to me. I mean, yeah, you came back, you got me because I had other things going on. And I don't talk to one about my issues and my problems all the time. So I kind of just go through my stuff silent. I have same thing. I could tell the world what happened, but it's not their business. I don't do that. So I don't make no excuses. I don't cry. I keep it moving. You understand me? That was the hardest fight I ever had with that first fight.
Roy, a lot of fighters are getting movies made about themselves. Are they doing one about you? And if they did one, who would you want to play you? And what would we find out about you in it?
I probably want Cuba Gooding Jr.
I can see that.
Because he probably looked the closest. And I don't know what you might find out. What you might find out about me is that, you know, I'm probably the coolest guy to ever walk the face of the earth. And if you ever want to have a good friend, you probably couldn't find a better friend to have Roy Jones Jr. And if you ever want to just wake up and get you a good laugh, call Roy, he'll give you something to laugh about.
What about Martin Lawrence? Even, you know, he could box.
Martin Lawrence can box.
Yeah, he could box. He goes to the gym every day. Well,
we that's good. Yeah, he might be good.
How much of you was God given and how much was you working hard in the gym to reach whenever you were at?
All of you was God given. But God helps those who help themselves. So you got to work hard because those that was given a lot is expected. I was given a lot from God, so He expected a lot of me. That's why I'm still doing stuff now. That's why I'm trying to fight, commentate, and work on the same night because God gave me the talent to do all that. Nobody else can't do that, but I can.
When did you know you were different? Because the first time I saw you, hands down, moving around, you broke every rule. When did you know that you could get away with that stuff?
Well, I knew I was doing well about 5 years old.
What made you realize that?
I just knew how to get to grown people. I could get a grown people person mad enough to kill me. I was 5 years old. And not by aggravating them, I'll think on them to make them really want to kill me, and I'm still laughing at them. And that was not by pissing them off, but pissing them off mentally, though, not by doing that to them, just my mind. You understand me? When you could do that, that's what I thought Ali was doing to other boxers. That's why I realized that if somebody teach me how to throw my hands, I can do exactly what Ali is doing, because I'm doing it for a 5 years old.